How are you? I hope all of you are happy and healthy. So dear students, as you can see, today we are going to study past perfect tense. Okay? So let's see what is the use of past perfect tense very first, and after that, what is the helping verb and main verb of the past perfect tense. Okay? So dear students, very first, if we talk about the helping verb, so you can see here this point. In this tense, okay, it means to say in past perfect tense, we use helping verb had. What is the helping verb of past perfect tense? Had. And third form of the verb, third form of the main verb. Okay, students? So, whenever you see the structure of had plus third form of the verb, so you can say that is a simple, sorry, past perfect tense. Okay? Suppose that you have seen the structure had gone. So, you can see had and third form of the verb, so this is the structure of past perfect tense. Okay? Had sung. So had plus third form of the verb. So this is the structure of past perfect tense. Okay? So I hope you have got the helping verb and the main verb of past perfect tense. Okay? Okay dear? Now let's see the use of past perfect. What is the use? So dear students, we use the past perfect tense. Just remember the point. We use the past perfect tense to talk about, an action. We use present perfect tense to express an action, to talk about an action that happened before another action in the past. Is that clear? So we can say past perfect tense is the past of past. Okay? We can say past of past. Okay? You can understand it by the time. Suppose that this is a time. This is action past and this is action past. Okay? Suppose that we have two actions that happened in past. Okay? This action happened, but this action happened earlier than this action. If this action happened earlier than this one. So students, this action must be in past perfect and this action must be in past indefinite. Okay? Is it clear? So that is why I have told you we use past perfect tense to express an action that happened before another action is in the past. Before another action in the past. Okay? So you can see with the help of this timeline, suppose that we have two actions that happened in the past, this action and this action. But this action happened earlier than this one. So this tense of the action must be in past perfect tense. If this action happened earlier than that one, okay, so that action must be in past perfect tense. Okay? Is that clear? So that is why we call it in past of past. Okay? Past perfect tense is known as the past of past. You can see the example. Okay? When she reached the theater, the play had begun. So friends, here you can see we have two action, and both action had happened in the past. But you can see this action, the play had begun. The play had begun. Okay. Occurred earlier than this action. Okay. So that is why you can see the tense of this action is in past perfect tense, and this action in simple past.
The tune had run the rail
occurred earlier than this action. So that is why you can see this action has been mentioned in past perfect tense. Okay? So I hope you have got these all points very well. I give you 2 minutes to note down. After that, we will discuss the negative and interrogative structure of the past tense. Simple of past perfect tense. Okay? Note down. Okay. You can see them negative sentences. So here, as usual in negative sentence, we mention subject first. And after that, helping verb add and negative word not, then perform of the verb, then object and then position. Okay? You can see the example. She had not sung a sweet song okay she had not sung a sweet song so you can see had plus part form of the verb past perfect tense and not is the negative structure okay now see that next one We can say yes or no type. Yes or no type. So in that category, our helping verb will come first, then subject, perform of the verb, object, etc., and at last mark of interrogation. Okay. If we talk about the second category, so you can say start with it. Function more. You can say WH family. Okay? So if we talk about the second category, start with WH family. So WH family will come first. So very first you will mention question word and after that you will mention the category first I mean helping verb then subject then third form of the verb object can pause through it, watch the video, enjoy the video, and note down these all points. Okay? Take care.